I'm John Jorgensen with Long & Foster and Stanley Martin Custom Homes. I'm going to talk a little bit about square footage and how Stanley Martin calculates square footage in their homes, as well as the cost per square foot numbers. So before I get started, I want to mention that Stanley Martin follows ANSI guidelines. It's A-N-S-I. So if you type A-N-S-I and square footage into your search engine, it'll bring up lots of great information. So at Stanley Martin, following the ANSI guidelines, we only count condition space above grade that you can walk on. So we don't count basements or garages or any two-story space that you cannot walk on towards the square footage of the home. In my first example, I start with a home that's 50 feet wide by 50 feet deep with no garage, no basement, no stairs. So just imagine it's a rambler. This particular home would be 2,500 square feet. So let's say hypothetically that this home costs $250,000. Your cost per square foot would be $100 per square foot. In the next example, I take the same 50 by 50 home and we add a 20 by 20 garage, which is 400 square feet. When you subtract that 400 square feet from the 2,500 square feet, you have a 2,100 square foot home. According to ANSI, you do not count garage space as square footage of a home. So let's say hypothetically, this home also costs $250,000. Now your cost per square foot is $119. So now let's take a look at what happens if we add a second floor to this same 50 by 50 home. So according to ANSI, you count the stairs as square footage to the floor from which they descend. So when you add a second floor to the home and there's stairs coming down from the second floor to the first floor, that area counts as square footage to the second floor. The space under the stairs would count towards square footage of the first floor. So when you add a second floor to a home and there's no two-story space, you count the whole 50 by 50 area, so you have 2,500 square feet on the second floor. So now you can add this 2,500 square feet to the 2,100 square feet we have on the main level, which gives us a home size of 4,600 square feet. So now let's take a look at what happens when you add two-story space. In this slide, we've added a two-story family room to the first floor of the home. By doing so, we've had to remove a 15-foot by 15-foot area from the walking space of the second floor. This is 225 square feet. So now we subtract that 225 square feet from the 4,600 square feet, and that leaves us with a home that is now 4,375 square feet. So let's say hypothetically that this home costs $500,000, your cost per square foot would be $114. All right, now let's take a look at the first floor master bedroom condition. In this example, we're going to start with a footprint of 70 feet wide and 50 feet deep because we need to add room for the master bedroom suite. So this home without a garage would be 3,500 square feet. Now we add a two-car garage. We're going to back out 400 square feet, and that'll bring us to 3,100 square feet. On a first-floor master bedroom condition, you typically only have a couple of bedrooms on the second floor. So instead of building out over the entire 3,100 square foot area, we're only going to build over 800 square feet. So the total square footage of this home is going to be 3,900 square feet. However, the cost per square foot goes up because you've got this big 70 foot wide by 50 foot deep foundation, you have a 70 foot wide roof by 50 feet deep, and you're only using 800 square feet of that second floor. So let's say hypothetically the price of this home is $600,000. This would make the cost per square foot $154. So the cheapest way per square foot to build a home is to have a box on a box. As soon as you start spreading out on that first floor level, you've got more concrete and you've got more roofing, and that drives your cost per square foot higher. So the next question is, what do you get for your money? So the cost per square foot is also based on the features that are in the home. What kind of flooring, what kind of siding, what kind of windows, what kind of roofing, what's the appliance package, do you have ceramic tile in the bathrooms, etc., etc. So to do an actual comparison from one home to another home on a cost per square foot basis, you need to first understand what the square footage is of the home on the two levels above grade, and then you need to understand what features are included in that price.